Welcome to Cape May! If you're looking to get away from it all, you've come to the perfect seaside resort. Sure, our beaches are eroding away and there are swarms of mosquitoes and sometimes the town catches on fire. But with entrepreneurs like you here, we'll be the queen of seaside resorts in no time. In Cape May, you'll travel the streets of our fine town, developing property, building wealth, and birdwatching. If at the end of four seasons you've earned the most prestige, you'll go down in history as the most successful developer of Cape May. Each season in Cape May consists of three rounds. At the start of each round, the first player will reveal an event card. A luxury steamship brings travelers, granting you additional income for your shops. Ooh, seasonal swarms of mosquitoes cause those tourists to flee, losing you money. A ghost may scare some birds. The president may visit. Or a section of town may catch fire. Yeah, that's gonna cost you. More than half of Cape May was destroyed by fire in 1878, but I'm sure you can take the heat. After resolving the event for the round, each player takes their turn, consisting of three actions. You can play a movement card, build or upgrade a cottage or shop, play an activity card, earn a little cash, or retrieve your movement cards. To take a move action, you'll play one of the movement cards from your hand, traveling the full amount listed on the card. Mind the one-way streets. Once you've discarded a card, you can't play it again until you've spent an action to retrieve all your discarded movement cards. So plan your route around town wisely. While traveling the streets of Cape May, you might land on a special space. If you land on a bird, you've spotted some avian wildlife. Collect sets of bird tokens for points. The lighthouse space gives you a discount to build on any empty lot. The pier space allows you to draw activity cards. When building a cottage or shop, you'll pay a cost according to the zone you're building in: gravel, grass, dirt, or sand. You'll also earn income according to what and where you build. Gravel and grass are accessible, but a little pedestrian. And the beachfront is highly desirable, but there is that little problem of extreme erosion and high prices. Upgrade your buildings to stay socially and historically relevant, and also to earn prestige points, which is how you win the game. When you upgrade a shop to a business, you'll earn an upgrade card, which will grant you an instant, one-time use, or ongoing effect that's sure to help you earn more prestige points than your fellow entrepreneurs. Activity cards also give you an advantage over the other players. They may allow you to build or upgrade at a discount or move to a specific location in town. At the end of the round, the lighthouse moves along the round wheel. On the game board, not in real life. Lighthouses can't just move whenever they want, it would be mayhem. At the end of the season, you'll gain income and activity cards to aid you as you enter a new season. At the end of the fourth season, you'll count your prestige earned for your buildings, your bird collections, your upgrade cards, and your secret bonus cards. You have been paying attention to those secret bonus cards, haven't you? Have I not mentioned those yet? At the beginning of the game, you'll choose two bonus cards to keep secret from the other players. These can help guide your strategy as you play. As the expert entrepreneur that you are, I'm sure you managed to have at least eight buildings adjacent to bird spaces. Didn't you? Whoever has the most prestige points wins. Congratulations! History will always remember you as the most successful developer of Cape May. At least until the next game.